Hi, I'm Ken Francis, and this is The Entire Gym. Have you ever been feeling like you just had some dumbbells? That's not The Entire Gym. Have you ever been feeling like maybe you just had some kettlebells? Well, guess what? That's not The Entire Gym. So I brought in my business partner, Isaac Bruce, and Lamar Jackson to help tell you about The Entire Gym.
I think the audio syncing might need some work there, Ken. I think we're gonna have to get you back in the booth, and we'll take it from the top.
From the top. Hi, my name is Ken Francis, and I had a question. Have you ever just been lifting some dumbbells at home and thinking, "Wow, this isn't the entire gym"? Have you ever been swinging a kettlebell and just thought to yourself, "What the heck? I need the entire gym"? Well, do I have a surprise for you. Introducing The Entire Gym. A gym in its entirety. It's everything you could possibly want. Now, here are my business partners, Isaac Bruce and Lamar Jackson, doing some really cool exercises.
You got a great ass.
If you use The Entire Gym. Okay, that's enough fun. We're back on the X of 52 podcast. It is one of the it's one of the weirdest Thursday nights we've probably ever had in our time doing podcasting across either platform, in our time as Ravens fans.
Might be the weirdest hour in my life as a Ravens fan.
My name is Jake Luke. I'm joined on my screen. We're live here. We're trying to space the lives out a little bit, try to give it a little bit more gravitas, but it felt like this one really called for it because the Ken Francis entire gym saga has played out before our very eyes, like within less than 2 hours. So I was driving home, getting close to home, when it broke that Lamar Jackson and we might as well come up with a category for pods like this, call it hashtag Lamar Watch or something like that. Cause you know, there's no new updates or everything. And it's kind of just like the Cuban Missile Crisis, right? We're just sitting in just whatever it is, but there are some entertaining updates here or there. This was the most entertaining of all, when I believe it was Rappaport who put it out that the NFL had informed clubs not to negotiate with a man by the name of, first the name was not released. So it came out that Lamar's friend, or maybe it was phrased as his mother's friend, was reaching out to teams on his behalf to try and drum up some negotiations. The NFLPA, or maybe it was the NFL, said not to negotiate with this man.
I think it was the NFL Management Council. I don't believe it was the PA. I think it was like corporate office.
I'm just going to go to I'll go to my Twitter profile, because I think I was kind of tweeting along with this whole thing, which
we've got Tom Pelissero who goes,
Pelissero was all over it. Yeah.
And NFL Management Council warning teams not to negotiate with a man named Ken Francis about Lamar Jackson. Quote, violation of this rule may result in disapproval of any offer sheet or resulting player contract entered into by Mr. Jackson and the new club, with a weird period in there. And then he posted the entire memo. I don't have to read the whole thing, but the first paragraph is, oh, pardon me, it was the NFLPA. The NFLPA has informed us that a person by the name of Ken Francis, so corporate was referred to by the PA, who is not an NFLPA certified agent, may be contacting clubs and attempting to persuade club personnel to enter into negotiations with or concerning Lamar Jackson, who is currently under a non-exclusive franchise tender with the Baltimore Ravens. Then it just goes on to reiterate, that's not allowed. That can cost you. There are fines. There are penalties.
Yeah, and then so we had Pelissero after that. Ken Francis is a Florida man who most recently was pitching a home fitness invention, I'm told. He now is trying to negotiate a 9-figure contract with NFL teams. 9 figures who are being told that they're 9 times who are being told that they're not allowed to negotiate with him because he's not a certified agent. And that came from the NFLPA. That's when stuff started to get fun. People were starting to get the Florida man jokes off, which was just the fucking tip of the iceberg here. I'd started to do some digging. I found the entire gym on LinkedIn pretty quickly. I think I was the first to this, so credit me for the entire gym thing. But the entire gym on LinkedIn, or it's Ken Francis on LinkedIn with the entire gym as his profile picture. Founder of the entire gym at the entire gym, LLC. The C is not capitalized. I don't know if that's correct. Daytona State College, Miami, Fort Lauderdale area. And in my tweet, all it says is how TEG began. At the time in 2016, the market only offered expensive, bulky, and the conventional oversized equipment for Seymour. I'm not going to read more because it's not important. But then below that, you get the Ken hasn't posted lately, 57 followers. I started to have fun at this point. I did the we're better than you and we know it little Globo Gym shout out. We had we had all sorts of good things coming out. Yuri had a good Wolf of Wall Street tweet. A lot of good stuff coming out. But this is where Lamar starts to jump in, and he quote tweets Pelissero with the Florida Man tweet saying, "Stop lying. That man never tried to negotiate for me." Your thoughts at this point?
So at first I was like, well, you know, if he's got someone in his team, I can't remember who told me. Bank said it wasn't him, but a while ago someone was like, yeah, you know, Lamar has a team. Like, it's not, everyone keeps saying it's his mom and there's all these jokes. It's his mom. It's not his mom. Like, he has a team of people and investors and, like, quote unquote lawyer types. So to me, I was like, well, you know, St. Omni's in the news all the time doing something similar, not certified, whatever the heck goes on. I don't know. St. Omni is like, I don't know, one of Kanye West's children. I don't know. The mythological figure to me. I just know Laramie Tunsil and Roquan Smith have worked with St. Omni as a mentor, negotiator, whatever, advisor. So I was like, all right, well, you know, it's weird. I don't get why you don't use an agent versus using a non-certified agent. But I tweeted out, was like, nonetheless, you know, it adds to the strange two-year intriguing saga of Lamar Jackson's quote-unquote negotiations. And so then at that point, Lamar hadn't tweeted anything yet. And then he goes ahead and quote tweets it, "Stop lying, that man never tried to negotiate for me." So in my head, I was like, well, if he didn't try to negotiate, he definitely was reaching out to teams, right? Like, someone was. That has been widely reported. Someone's reaching out to teams, trying to drum up interest. That doesn't mean he's quote-unquote negotiating, but it's trying to lure in a negotiation. I don't know. So Ken Francis is involved in some capacity, and the absolute legend of Ken Francis grew from zero to a million in a span of, maybe 26 minutes, I think.
Yeah.
So from there, it was just I'm in a blender. There's where I was like, all right, I'm getting into blender territory.
Yeah, it's a true mind fuck because of what we're going to get to. But yeah, he tweets out that "stop lying, that man never tried to negotiate for me." And so that's where I think we're kind of getting into technicality territory where it's like, okay, maybe he didn't negotiate for you, but like, did he, you know, was he reaching out? Was he trying to gauge interest? Was he trying to drum interest up? Who knows? And so that's kind of where it got a little weird. But he also had this tweet, which was fun, a little bit after that. Let me see if I can pull it up here. But it's the famous Ben Affleck smoking meme. He's just looking absolutely miserable. Notably, he's wearing his Lamar Jackson Ravens number 8 jersey, which a lot of people really, really liked. They took that to mean something good. Love to see Garnett and the boys in the LeCheap space.
So he's back.
So he tweets out the Ben Affleck thing with his jersey on. "This is every day, but quote, it's okay not to be okay. Mental health awareness." So
I don't know what to make of that. I have no idea.
He probably is. Some people were maybe not too happy with that. I thought it was kind of funny. Like, he probably is pretty fed up with all this stuff. You know, I tend to think that maybe a lot of this could have been alleviated with him getting an agent, but we don't have to get too serious with this. I'm kind of just having fun with the,
at this point, like we've been having fun for probably a week or two, really since the tender happened, I think. And like maybe a day after we've really started to have fun here.
Yeah, no, it's great. And that's, so basically that's kind of where it started to end or die down a little bit. I really didn't want to, I kept going. I did the Murphy group, you know, when E's got his own agency going on, I did some boiler room. I had some fun with this thing. And then Lamar had more fun than any of us because just a few minutes after he tweeted the Ben Affleck thing, let me see if I can pull up the exact timeline. But yeah, it was literally not even probably an hour later, he tweets out a video that we played at the top for you of the entire gym commercial, which it got a little garbled with you talking over it with your sales pitch, but that's okay.
I couldn't even hear that. Okay. I didn't know.
Okay, my bad. Yeah, no, it. But that's okay. Like it... He tweets this out 46 minutes ago. "My business partner Ken and I will be dropping the entire gym this summer. Hashtag stay tuned. Hashtag truz." So it comes down to this whole thing, and I'm following the entire gym.
The graphics on the commercial trailer, whatever you want to call it, are so funny to me. I can't even possibly express.
It's the fucking best. And like I try, you bet your
Here's
ass.
Lamar Jackson doing Russian twist. Here's Lamar Jackson throwing a football.
Yeah.
Here's the total gym.
You bet your ass. I'm following the entire gym on Twitter. Right
Pardon
now.
Me, the entire gym, not to be in confused with the total gym, which has existed for 20 plus years, I believe.
What's your
not
mom?
The same thing at all. Not a ripoff of the total gym. Definitely not.
For sure not. It comes with an iPad. I'm pretty well. It might be sold separately. Actually, we're gonna have to get into that.
It comes with an iPad sold separately. That's what it says.
Yeah, for sure. So yeah, that's and then you know that's kind of when the questions start to be asked. Was this the greatest marketing ploy literally ever?
Tom Pelissero then caps us off with, so to recap, the NFL told teams today they are prohibited from negotiating with a Florida man named Ken Francis, legend, whom Lamar Jackson says never tried to negotiate for him, but is his business partner on a forthcoming home fitness invention with a commercial starring Lamar. Then when my brain went to just straight mush was that Rappaport tweeted, quote tweeted the video of the entire gym and says, stay tuned. I don't know what's going on. I don't know. Let's see how many followers the entire gym has now. 318. I can't imagine they had more than six to begin with. So
I'm one of them now, as is a friend of the program, sure. Kyle Andrews and Ryan Schell.
I'm just in a blender now. It follows ESPN.
This episode is literally sponsored by them and you can't get the name right. I'm gonna have to.
The entire gym. It's the entire gym. You don't need a total gym. You need the entire thing.
Great ass.
ESPN, Lamar, Amanda Cerny, who in her bio says not a financial advisor.
I don't know who that is.
Not a financial advisor. Comedy is life. Ryan Clark, the Baltimore Ravens, and RG3. That is who the entire gym's account follows.
I don't know who Amanda Cerny is.
I don't know either. All I know is that she's not a financial advisor and she has 1.2 million followers.
Definitely don't know. yeah, that's... I don't know. I don't know. All I know is this is great. I mean, what a ride. What a ride this has been. And
who would have thought, 5 years ago? What, I don't know. Five years ago, the Ravens draft Lamar Jackson. He's this controversial. Oh, is he a running back? Oh, my gosh. Joe Flacco. What the heck? Who could have possibly thought that it would lead to the entire gym saga of Thursday, March 23rd at approximately... 6 p.m. Just truly one of the most strange, eclectic, weird situations that could possibly transpire over the last 2 years, really, since the quote-unquote negotiations opened up. We have an all-time comment here live from UNI Panther 043. Lamar Jackson can be ours for $3,336,113 payments of $59.95. Might even get a home gym, too.
Wow.
Now that's a bargain.
You gotta bake in, like, if they do get them to sign a contract, they gotta bake in some kind of marketing deal to help get this thing off the ground. It is very much an investor's possibly you situation, where if he goes into that negotiating room with Ken on one side and he's got Eric DaCosta on the other side of the table, we're fucking packing in some promotion for the entire gym. And that's gonna be just like how Brady made money off of Giselle. This is how he's gonna make his nut on the side.
Wow. Ken Francis is Lamar Jackson's Giselle.
There we go.
I think we figured it out.
Wow.
That's huge.
That is huge. Wow. Groundbreaking. Ken Francis coming to you live. The entire gym. Not part of it. Not half of it. Not just dumbbells. Not just kettlebells. The entire gym.
I mean, this thing
comes with an iPad sold separately.
It strengthens your entire core. Your back core. Your...
Your front core, your
the Marine Corps actually used it. I think that's how they got core.
It is the Marine Corps. If you want a Marine Corps, the entire gym is for you. $59.95 iPad comes with an iPad sold separately.
Yeah, yeah. I mean, I hope it's sold separately. I feel like that would be kind of a tough cost to bake in there for a home gym.
It comes with an iPad that is sold separately. So that's the whole deal.
It's kind of like a Peloton situation where you have to buy both the machine and the membership every month.
And the iPad, but it comes with the iPad.
Yeah, of course. Yeah, listen.
Of course. It's very straightforward. So
these are all just semantics. Do you want to get fucking shredded or not? That's my question to you.
if you want your entire core to experience an entire gym, I've got something for you. I've got a little surprise for you. Investors, possibly you.
You put your feet into the power stirrups and you raise your hands overhead to the bars.
Very like, it's just like being at the OBGYN. You'll never Kegel harder than you will with the entire gym. I will. There's the what is the Bleacher Report series called where they do the little cartoons, the Gridiron Heights? Oh my God! Can they just make one? Can they make one of Lamar and Ken Francis and then Lamar's mom going into the Indianapolis Colts like boardroom and meeting with Jim Irsay and him being like, okay, like what are the terms, Lamar? And he's like, well, I brought Ken here and he's going to tell you about the entire gym. And Jim Irsay is just like smoking pot, like bumps a line, like just out of control. Gridiron Heights, come on. Can we get one? Can we get one off season Gridiron Heights?
We were talking a little bit about this in the GC, and it's like, I think the question came up. I don't know who raised it, but it's like, is any team going to want to deal with this right now? And like, to me, this makes him more appealing to Jim Irsay. This is like, wow, look at this entrepreneurial young man. I really dig it. How about we get him into the negotiating room and see if I can give up these two first round picks? Hey, Lamar, what's up, man? I don't really work out much, but I like the hustle. You know what I'm saying?
Then he just has an emphysema cough that comes out for the next 60 seconds of the video.
There's a big smoker's cough. There's
and I just and like at first I was like, well, okay, this is some traction. Like, okay, I'm probably gonna, you know, I'm not trying to have takes, but I feel like, all right, you know, the same Omni. Now I just there's no takes to be had, and there's gonna be a million takes of like, well, he's an entrepreneur. Oh, well, you know, what the hell is he doing? He needs an agent. Oh, and there's just gonna be like online anonymous people just clapping at each other, and I'm just here to see how shredded I can get in my leg core with the entire gym.
It strengthens your entire core. Yeah. Like I think we had the, at least I had the semi-serious take when it first came out, or not even semi-serious, but like, why not just hire an agent? Like, I feel like David Mulligetta would literally do this for pro bono and then like, you know, keep him for whatever endorsement deals he might sign him to. But yeah, he's just not going to do it, man. Like he's not. And like, this is what we're, it's only going to get weirder from here, I think. And
first I felt like it was like the meme of like, you know, from Bird Song, whatever the hell that Sandra Bullock movie's called.
Bird Box
of the man holding the woman's eyes open and being like the Baltimore Ravens. Like, look at what we've been trying to do. He keeps bringing Ken Francis in here. He can see Steve Bisciotti, Ken Francis, Lamar and Lamar's mom. And they're like, Lamar, what do you want? And he's like, an investment. What do you not understand? It's the entire gym, Steve.
It's literally the entire gym, all like in one package with an iPad that is sold separately but comes with it.
And we've got you and I, Panther, here. We need a meme of Lamar walking on Shark Tank, but it's NFL owners sitting there waiting for the sell. Why doesn't Lamar just go on Shark Tank? Can we get a Lamar and Ken Francis Shark Tank episode? Mark Cuban would eat it up.
Yeah, I think Mr. Wonderful would probably give him literally all the money.
It's going to end up on HSN. I mean, it's going to be three sharks minimum.
You get like a, I feel like you get a Kevin O'Leary op-ed about like how work from home is actually a bad thing. Like every 6 months, you feel like, you know, if you sell him on this concept of a home gym, maybe he'll change his tune.
That's true. Mr. Wonderful will change his tune for one Lamar Jackson.
Yeah. I mean, I guess that's the only semi-serious take that I had was why not just, you know, go to Mulligetta and say, hey, just take care of this for me. But
that's how I felt the entire time. It's like, if you want the Watson deal or you want to beat it, why not get the guy who did the Watson contract? The maximum amount he can take is 3%. And if you're off by 20%, that's a little bit of meeting in the middle there, barely. So I don't know, man.
I think he would do it for no commission. I really
like 1%, 2%. You know, they're not trying to fight for the maximum still because 0% of zero is freaking zero, man. They want something.
He's got all the money. He could be the guy that he could be the big, he's already kind of the big swinging dick amongst the agents. And he could say, I got this guy a deal.
I got him the entire deal.
The entire deal. And I got the entire gym on a billboard in Times Square.
The entire deal is guaranteed.
Yeah.
It's an entire gym.
I got a lot of literature that I could bring your way. That some really disruptive stuff we've got going on here with the entire gym.
I mean, get Ken Roy in there, man.
Dude. Yeah. The thing
is, even friends cracking up over here.
The thing is fucking off the chain, Dad. I'm telling you, it strengthens your entire fucking core. Okay, get the fuck out of here.
What are you talking about? What's an entire core, Kendall?
Yeah, Dad, fuck off. Okay, I just need you to throw me a fucking bone on this one. All right, climb down out of my ass, Dad. What the fuck?
Ah, fuck off. I've never heard of an entire core.
Entire gym? You need an entire kick in the ass, son. Get your shit together. Fuck off.
Remember that boy you killed? I sure do.
You're my number one boy. Ken Francis is my number one boy.
My number one boy. Ken Francis.
I can't wait for that. That's Sunday night, right?
What is? Yes, it is.
Yeah.
They just had their premiere in the Big Apple, the big one, the big city, the entire city.
Last season. Yeah, it's the entire city. Yeah.
Well, with that, I guess we can bid you adieu, but we were brought here by the entire gym. It has been an entire saga. It's been an entire night, and I'm scintillated. I can't wait for what comes next. This is going to reach, like, all-time levels, and people are starting to – I'm just excited. I'm just floored. I'm ready. I'm ready for what's next.
Oh, man. This is yeah, this has been
a fun. Yes, and Yuri in the comments here, my favorite part was the random 3-second clip of him throwing a seed after doing Russian twists with a shake weight. It was his entire core, Yuri. I mean,
yeah,
I mean, what was not to love about that?
He fired his entire pelvis to get through that ball. I mean, the entire gym is.
Do you want to juke defenders? Do you want to throw piss missiles? You think you can do that with part of a gym? Hey, why don't you try the entire gym?
Do you want to walk up walls and flip over defenders? Do you want to leave Logan Wilson just, you know, flying into the ether? The entire gym is for you.
I'm Ken Francis, and I'll leave you with this. Play by the rules, but be ferocious. Phil Knight, Ken Francis, Michael Scott.
Learn the rules of the game and then step into the game. Yeah, okay. Yeah, for anyone that was expecting like some sort of serious like podcast or analysis today, we apologize. But
I've got nothing left. I've got nothing left for the Ravens. I've got nothing left for Lamar. I'm just watching. I'm just watching. I'm here for the ride.
There's nothing to do. I mean, you've got DeAndre Hopkins floating around, maybe with some Bills rumors out there.
Adrian Amos comes to town. Definitely had a couple crab cakes. He's familiar with them.
People were happy about that. Yep, Adrian Amos.
People were thrilled about that one.
Nelson Aguilar has visited.
Nelson Aguilar has been here, has had the crab cakes, has gone home.
Yeah.
Because he had to work out his entire core.
Yeah. And it strengthens
the offseason. It's time. You can't just be here, Jimmy Seafood, yucking it up. You got half of a gym, you need an entire gym.
Yeah. Get the entire gym, get the entire half and half from Jimmy Seafood, and have yourselves an entirely good weekend, guys. Thank you for listening. Like I said, we were just kind of having some fun.
I do have Ken's email if anyone has any inquiries.
Do you?
Oh, I do. I want you to guess what it is. Please guess his email.
k.francis@gmail.com.
Very close. ken@theentiregym.com.
Of course. Okay. Wait, can we effort an interview there?
Yes. I'm going to send one right now.
All right, good. Okay. Well, yeah, I've been trying to say, thank you guys for listening. We
investors, possibly
Jacob. Possibly you. Yeah, we
possibly us.
We had to fire it up and discuss this, even if it was just a rambling 25 minutes of fucking nonsense. But that's what we love about this crazy thing of ours that we do. And days like this are why we do it.
It's Ken Francis's rock. We're just spinning on it.
We're all just living on it. yeah, thank you guys once again for listening in, and we will talk to you, who knows, next week. I mean, maybe an update's coming again soon. Maybe we'll get some more entire gym stuff that we'll have to dice up here.
I think Lamar Jackson's going to be the lead in a sitcom soon. So that's my dark horse. That's what's next.
He could be following in the footsteps of former NFL players that have become actors. Hopefully not all the way. But yeah, you can follow us on Twitter. I'm at Jake Luke. That's LOUQUE. Spencer is at Ravens for Dummies. That is the number 4. Check us out at Exit52 Podcast on Twitter and Instagram. And you can find us on YouTube too. We streamed this one live. Probably going to be going live shortly here with a 5-man weave soon as the month comes to an end. Just do a little check in with all the boys. But yeah, tune back in for the flagship feed with the 3 fellas. We'll continue to mix things up. You know, I was on with Eric and Taylor, or Brian and Eric the other night. Hopefully Taylor will be back from Portugal soon. And yeah, we'll just keep mixing it up. It's been a fun start so far, and this was maybe the most fun day of them all. So thank you guys for listening. We'll be back soon, like I said, and have yourselves a entirely great weekend.
See ya entirely.
Arrivederci.
Boy, what is it you want to do when you grow up?